this cable is all what I need to connect PlayStation, Xbox, anything to Quest. I don't need a capture card. I don't need HDMI cable. I don't need extension cable. This is all what I need. This is brand new. It's not the same cable what I showed you before. So this looks almost the same. It's not. This is so much more than normal cable, but it's super cheap. It's about $20. So this is your only expense you'll have. And so normally, for example, I have here Apple TV, but it could be Xbox or anything else. So normally I would need this cable to capture card and capture card to my headset, but to make it comfortable to not destroy a headset port, I need also extension cable. And if everything was connected, then I could open HDMI link and watch movie in good quality like right now. But right now I disconnected all of this, and now I will show you how it can be done much more simple. This goes here. I will connect power. This power goes to Quest because I want to charge it, and this here. Okay. It is connected. Play. Done. So it works like X-ray glasses or something like that. X-ray glasses. This cable has built-in HDMI capture card. So the capture card is here. And this is really good capture card. You will get maximum quality Quest can use. So 60 frames per second in YUY 2. So this is extremely simple right now. It has the same issue like normal HDCP card. Like if I connect it upside down, it will work as USB 2 and it will use different format. You see here now, it's not 60 frames per second anymore and not YUY anymore. So I just mark it and I always know how to connect it. As you see, I'm connecting power at the same time, and the power can be connected all the time. This is issue with many power delivery hubs with like Quest don't like when we connect data and charging at the same time. And what I noticed when our power supply supports 12 volts, it's better than 9. 9 volts makes more problems. Which is strange because usually Quest choose 9 volts if he can. But with this card, we will get always 12 volts. Only if power supply doesn't support it, then it will use 9. So that's great. Maybe this is some bug in MetaOS. Maybe one day they will fix it and on every power supply will be great. For now, it's not. So when I use this power supply with 12 volts, is perfect. You may wonder, if you bought already this cable, HDMI to USB-C with power delivery, I showed this in one of my previous videos, and this capture card, if this was wrong decision. No, it was great because this is still the best setup. With this, you can connect absolutely everything, even Nintendo Switch without the dock, and you can charge ROG Ally, Steam Deck and anything else, and not only Quest. So this is the ultimate setup, the best of the best. This one, and of course I will link to everything in the description and to my previous video. So if you have this already, you're set. But maybe you won't have this more simple. and maybe you don't need charging the other device because the other devices, Xbox or a PlayStation or smart TV or anything like that, then this is a better choice because you just connect this cable and that's done. I can also connect it to Switch, but I need dock like that. This is dock. This is very small. It's not the original dock, but it's dock. Okay, so now it's connected. Oh, it's already here. And it's working. So $18 is not no-brainer. 18, 20, something like that. If you can, buy both setups and use them depending what you need currently. If you cannot, then you choose whatever you need more. But this card with power delivery and this cable is more universal. It's more like with this, you can connect absolutely everything. And if you cannot use this cable because it's USB-C, then you connect normal HDMI cable and that's it. Okay, so all the links are in the description. I got this for free. I didn't pay for it. They sent it to me for tests. And for what I see, it works perfectly. If you worry about the power delivery, the 12 volt, which I mentioned, don't worry about this. It's better for what I notice, but even the original power supply from Quest is still working. Only if you will have an issue, connect first the cable and power later. But it was always like this with Quest, so I thought that it will be always like that and it's impossible to fix it. And accidentally I just thought solution. But maybe it's just another bug, maybe it's different for you. Okay, that's it. See you.